You said, son, you see the world. What would you say if I said that you could just carry this gun? And you'll even get paid. I said, that's not really good. Black leather boots, spit. Cut off my hair, but it looked all right. We marched and we sang, we all became friends as we learned our old friends. A hero born, yeah, that's what I'll be. And when I come home, there'll be damn proud. Carry this flag to the grave if I must, 'cause it's a flag that I love and a flag that I trust. I kicked in the door, I yelled my commands. The children they cried, but I got my hand. They took him away. Took off his clothes, they pissed in his hands, told them to stop, but then I joined in. They beat him with guns and batons, not just once, but again and again. She walked through bullets and hate. Asked her to stop, I begged her to stay, but she pressed on. So I lifted my gun and I fired her away. And the shells jumped through the smoke and into the sand. Son, if you seen the world, what would you say if I said that you could?
The Hero of War was one of those songs where I felt like there was this huge issue that nobody was talking about in the music, you know? Like, where are the songs that are talking about what's happening in our country and in this time of war? And talking about what's happening specifically to the people that are being asked to go fight this war and asked to lay down their lives for this war. I was meeting troops all over the world, and they were telling me stories that I felt like weren't stories that I was reading in headlines. These were different stories. These were stories about what this war was doing to them. I would get an email and it would be like, "Dear Rise Against, I've been a Marine for 8 years. I've served here, here, and here. I just heard your song, Hero of War, and nobody has ever put into a song what I feel like. Thank you for writing it." And then another email, almost identical. Dear Rise Against, I've been a Marine for 8 years. I've served here, maybe the same places. Shame on you for writing that song. If someone's like, yo, I like your band, but I have a problem with your song, Hero of War. Hero of War is an honest song about things that are really happening. If you have a problem with Hero of War, then you have a problem with the truth. And if you have a problem with the truth, then you're gonna have a lot of problems to Rise Against. I wanna say things that are putting water where the fires are, and that's what the lyrics are. And they're for me, too. They're just me, I guess, just venting. And even though they're for me, they're also for the person that reads them and can identify with them and then feel less alone. Because that's what lyrics were for me when I was growing up, was a way that I could read them and be like, that's so awesome that I'm not the only person in the world that feels like this. I just read this guy's lyrics and now I know that he feels like that too sometimes. Much of my tumultuous adolescence is behind me and I can sing about it now in sort of retrospect, but when I see like a kid in front of me singing it, I realize, oh man, he's going through this like today, you know, like tonight. Like he's going through it right now. You know, to witness that sort of transformation is something that's really powerful.
As we etch them with our fingers in years of wet cement, they'd blood into each other, though everything seemed clear. We cruise along at half speed, but then we shift the gears. We ran like vampires from our elves, burning suns. Even then we should have stayed, but we ran away. We've outgrown all the things that we once loved. Run away, hey! But what are we running from? A sharp hand of those in the darkness of one. Where have they gone? Identities assume us. It's not if I add up. Synchronizing watches to the seconds that we're lost. And I looked up and saw you. I know that you saw me. We froze but for a moment in empathy. I brought down the sky for you, but all you did was shrug. Gave my emptiness a name. Then you ran away. We've outgrown all the things that we once loved. Run away, but what are we running from? Sharp hands on those in the silence of one. Where have they gone? And we almost won. We slammed the brakes, but the wheels went on. So we ran away. Now all my friends are gone. Maybe we've outgrown all the things that we once loved. Run away.
I grew up skateboarding. I used to take the train downtown and skateboard, and that's how I met a lot of people in the punk rock scene in Chicago. And actually, we're driving right past a place that used to be called Wrigley Side. My old band 88 Fingers Louie played there with bands like Captain Jazz and, you know, all the local Chicago bands, Psychic Cato, Bull Weevils, No Empathy. Chicago kind of had these weird places where it was like the main place for touring bands to come to, and then it would just disappear. It was a lot of fun because it was wherever we could, you know, that's where we played. The Fireside Bowl was a venue inside a bowling alley. The Fireside was so important to the punk rock scene in Chicago. When you weren't big enough to play the Metro or the Vic, it was the only place you could play. We're actually driving up to the place I started going to shows. It was called Medusa's, and it was right here on this corner. It was this door right here.
It was up these steps. It's crazy. This venue right here was called Medusa's. It was where I started going to shows. I saw Agnostic Front play here. I saw DRI play here. Circle Jerks, Murphy's Law, all those bands that had a huge impact on my life. You know, I was probably 13, 14 when I started going to shows. It's no longer Medusa's, apparently it's Apartments. I had no idea what was here. Venues would come and go, but the same scene, it would just move like that, and then move here. And like for like whatever year, however long venues would be around. I think what really changed my life was at the Vic Theater. My first show was the Bad Brains. And I walked in and I was like, my jaw dropped. HR, singer of the Bad Brains, was doing backflips. I was just like, oh my God. It was me and two other friends, and we basically looked like, you know, we came from the suburbs, you know, which we did. And I hid out in that corner over here. I think it was kind of right around here, so I kind of just watched. I just remember the Bad Brains taking stage, and the whole place just like exploded. Yeah, but I was still too scared to go in the pit. I really wanted to, you know, and then a month later, the Circle Jerks, it was my first pit that I was in, and it was awesome. This is literally where it all started for me, and the fact that like right there was my first pit ever. I haven't been to a show yet that topped that show, and that was in 89. You know, a lot of people ask, like, what's the inspiration for Rise Against? And for me, it's that show. I always want to try to put forth the energy that they did, you know, that night.